Good morning and welcome to Monday, the 23rd of January, 2012. It's lovely to see you all, especially you.
How are you, Karl? I'm so glad to see you. It's been a whole month, folks. I just don't want to leave makeup on his collar because that's never a good look. Doesn't go down well with the other wife.
Hold it.
Actually, Cass is fine about it. Just shut up and hug me. Hey, is that what that is?
That's a nice hug.
I should go away for a month.
Is he going to sleep?
Cass has warned me about that.
It's nice to see you. Did you have a good break?
I had a fantastic break. Would you like me to tell you all about it?
Well, yes, I do. But during the course of the next, you know.
3.5.
Back to Georgie Gardner.
Yes. Hello, gang.
Oh, no.
He fell asleep on my shoulder yesterday, Georgie. It lasted that long. You're lucky you've got a computer between you two.
That's not all easy. Yes, good morning. Good to see you all.
They're holed up in their Brentwood estate. I say they're making up right now, but I could be wrong. Percentage, I say these divorce reports are 70% false.
70% false. Okay, well, we're looking forward to having Seal here in Australia doing the voice.
That's what you're thinking.
So that's 70% false. So that would be 30%. Yeah. Hey, listen, Jennifer Aniston is taking a break from Tinseltown, and you've got a theory on that as well.
Jen has said she is taking a break from Hollywood after she does publicity for her new movie. But we caught this photo of her over the weekend. You know, really like kind of buckled up, kind of bundled up in a bowl. Coat. You know what? I say these rumors, they are intensifying and it could be possible. She could be in a family way.
She's either pregnant or cold, one or the other.
Right? Thank you. It is winter over here. I'm hedging my bets, man.
Hey, you're on fire today. We'll try again in another hour. We'll see you then, buddy boy.
Is it possible for someone in Hollywood or you know, for a high profile couple to have, you know, it's rare that one lasts any longer than about 5 years.
Yeah, you have many lasting a long time. And apparently she's the one that's filing for divorce, not him. So, Seal, don't worry. Plenty more fish in the sea.
Yeah, well, he's going to be out here doing the... Oh, yeah, sorry.
Plenty more fish.
Slow burner.
Fish in the sea. Hey, that was a good one.
Thank you.
That was
you weren't expecting that, were we?
No, Seal.
Hey, Splitsville scuttlebutt is swirling, Richard Reed, about Seal and Heidi Klum. What's your take on all this divorce talk?
Well, you know what I gotta say, Richard? They are definitely on the rocks. Now, you know, Richard, I'm the first to jump.
I'm the first to jump on
the divorce bandwagon. But I am dragging my stilettos on this one. I say it is not a done deal yet.
On behalf of the official Sydney to Hobart organising committee.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
No, that's fantastic.
So there you go. And what we've done is we've just set aside the next 25 minutes of the show just for you to talk us
through the
entire
whole
race.
Experience.
That'll only just get us through the start photo, of course. So what happened was... it was a great experience. And look, let's be honest, I didn't do much on the vessel except be pretty crook.
Are you over your seasickness yet?
I don't want to talk about the ocean, Lisa.
That's kind of it, really.
I don't want to talk about the ocean ever again.
Speaking of which,
must be in the Mediterranean somewhere.
Time now for today's weather.
And you definitely don't want to... Carl's just broken his trophy. What is going on over there?
You can't leave stuff with boys. I just don't know what to do.
I'll fix it. Super glue.
We'll fix that up. Great. Is that 100 years of history you've just ruined, Carl? It's not for drinking out of, Carl.
There's nothing to see here, Stevie. Move on.
Clear the area. Move on.
Oh, dear.
Dickie, you do a lot of travelling. You're also a man of considerable size.
Thank you very much, Stevie.
And height.
Thank you. Look, this is ridiculous and completely unmanageable. It's a silly thing to suggest. For every fatty boomsticks on the flight, there's a skinny mini as well. It all evens out. Look, if you've got such a big butt that you can't squeeze into a seat, then you've got a problem. But in terms of charging people as to their weight, it's ridiculous.
Okay, in terms of breaking this down, Timmy, my suggestion earlier, we do it with our bag if your bag fits.
How humiliating would that be? Oh, no.
Well, it shouldn't be.
Imagine if you've got a lineup of 20 people and you're the big unit that can't quite squeeze in. Everyone's looking at you going, you.
That's a good point.
So discriminatory.
That's a good point.
You almost need another class. There you go. First business fat economy.
Look.
It's like, you know what I mean?
Which one are you,
Tom?
Now, this week is Australia Day, so Woolies launched a new campaign around meat. $10 off a leg of lamb is the two-day coupon offer. And this is incredible. So popular was the deal that on Sunday, Woolies sold 39,000 legs of discounted lamb. Wow. Think about it. 18,000 sheep. You don't get those off the back of a truck, do you? So think about how hard it is to work this all out.
Indeed. That's obviously proving incredibly popular. What's meant to be the next
the
deal?
Children, Ross. The children.
Sheep. All those sheep limping around.
Oh, those three-legged sheep.
It's very Australian, really, isn't it?
What is a front leash, Carlos? Because they're the sheep.
Walking around in a circle.
Tell them the back legs you use, Carlos.
It's really cool.
Oh.
Vegetarian.
We love a lamb shank. We love a lamb shank on this program.
Oh, especially Georgie's lamb shank.
Georgie's one.
Round of applause, everybody!
Jeez, I tell you what. Big Sam Kekovich. Am I that a sheep?
Not just a chop.
All right.
Sorry. Okay, I can speak.
Yeah, big Sammy and all. Big Sammy and all those sheep limping around, hey? You right there? No,
I'm in, Vicky. I must say, I wear flats a lot more often. I tend to just go to and from the studio with my high heels these days. I rarely go out with them. But yeah, I mean, the number of times I've had my feet up and Tim having to massage my balls because they're so sore.
Good thing it's not the other way around, I guess.
Don't you get sore balls?
I do. Yeah. But I must admit, I don't wear them very often. And the older I get, the less I wear high heels.
Thursday, the 26th of January. Happy Australia Day, everyone.
Oh, well done, Carl. Because Boo-Boo's Ellen's is so Australian.
It's not a vuvuzela.
What is it?
They're massively long, those things. This is an Aussie version.
A short
made in China.
And finally, is this the world's most stupid thief? An armed robber in Brazil held bank customers hostage while two accomplices filled a money bag. But it all came unstuck for the group when the clumsy gunman lowered his arm and accidentally shot himself in the foot. Oh. It wasn't a quick getaway for the robber, as you might imagine. With police picking him up after he turned up at the local hospital. Whoops.
He had to go to the hospital. He was a bit crook.
That's right. That's right. Well done.
Good.
Too good.
Well done.
It's Friday day.
It's very good.
Crook, crook.
Yeah. Love
a crooked crook, crook.
You could keep going.
but we won't.
How bad was that?
Finally, in the Northern Territory news, whet your appetite. Northern Territory locals are refusing to let the wild weather dampen their Australia Day celebrations. Good stuff.
Yeah, snag in the hand.
Yeah, two in the bush.
Yeah.
Something like that. Should I go home?
This is Australia Day.
No one's getting me today.
No, you've got to get out there, get amongst it, Lisa. It's Australia Day.
That's right.
It's perfect.
It is. And look what we've got.
Yes.
Little Australia Day shapes.
We do.
And what have you noticed as you've seen that? The map of Tassie is missing. But that's okay because there's fun for everybody because you get the crumbs and you do this.
You mean just Tassie is missing, not the map?
Am I got it in the right spot?
Yeah, he's going to make it a tiny bit smaller.
Maybe not underneath Western Australia.
Why does Tassie always get forgotten? Tassie always gets forgotten. Today at 9.com.au, why does Tassie always get forgotten? Let's get some gossip now with Ricardo.
I think I've got Tassie stuck in my teeth here.
Dickie. Oh, hey.
Maybe a bit of New Zealand.
Very good point. Have a great day, everybody. Hope it's fine in your neck of the woods, and if it isn't, it doesn't matter anyway. Celebrate. Have a great day.
Go the Angels.
Happy Australia Day.
Happy Australia Day.